So I bought some new fan brushes after I lost the one the other day. So I've still got some of my paint on here, which is good because it will match if I want to tint some of the clouds a bit, but I'm just going for a titanium white. Popping it on the palette and let's have a look. Let's have a little looky. I might want to turn that a little bit off. That I quite like. I think that's quite interesting. So let's go in here. I'm going to put some paint on the fan brush. Okay, load it up. Okay, and then up here. So I'm going to start this side, I think. Yeah. This looks like a cloud coming in here. Just dancing around. Dancing around. Just putting some light in. Put another little one up here. There. And then another here. Just some little indications of clouds in the sky. Another one up here. I'm going to carry on through here, doing almost like it's one of those, as I say, end of an evening, when you look up at the sky on a summer's day, and it's been a nice warm day, and your skin feels all nice and warm, as you've had some vitamin D soak into your bones. Another one up here. I'm going to put a little touch of the red on the underside of this one. Too much. Much. Put it down with a bit of white. And they're all kind of generally going in the same direction, aren't they? Yeah. Just a little indication, not much. Just enough for you to know that there's a cloud right there going off the page. How about that? Going off. These are just these little fluffy ones. Ones. Going off the side as well. What do we think? This one up there. Coming along over here. And kind of there. How's that? Yeah. I like this little collection around here. I think that's rather nice. Right, now what we're going to do is, you don't just see clouds like that, we're going to lift them gently, to just to make them fluff them up a little bit. little line underneath, almost marking it out a bit more. There we go. Right, so I'm kind of happy with that as a base. When it's dried a little bit more later, I might put a couple more little highlights under there, but I'm going to leave that and let that sink in for a bit, because I quite like how that's going. I like this little depth here. Okay, great. So that's the sky. Now, I'm not going to do a mountain this time, but I would quite like a hill, I think. So shall I do the hill? I'll do the hill this side, and then put some trees. Then we can pull the reflection down, and then maybe put a little island here or something. So we need the colours for a hill. So if you're thinking, if you want a hill further in the background, then it needs to be lighter. The closer you come to the foreground, then it gets darker. So let me get some fresh paints. Leave that palette separately. So I will be going for because it's quite a sort of sunsetty scene. I don't want to be black mountain because it wouldn't. Well, it's not that dark. There's still some light in it. So I'm actually going to go for sort of. Not purple, I do like purple. I did purple in my last one actually, didn't I? But I'm going for a bit of, I've got a bit of violet blue, violet, rose red, and I'm going to put a touch of ripe sienna in it to bring it a bit more earthy. So those are the colours that I have. Get my palette knife to mix it up. I love that, you see all the different. Remember, you can make a mountain whatever colour you want. It's your mountain, as Bob would say. This is my mountain. Well, it's not a mountain. It's not going to be a mountain. Okay, so. Now. I do have quite a lot of paint already. Okay, so I'm going to put the mountain here, I think. Yeah, and then put some trees in front. So I want this, it's going to be in the background, so I do need a touch of white. I'm going to keep some of the darker colour for the front. Yeah, but I just need smidge lighter for the background, okay. Let's just take some of this paint off here because it's quite a bit and it's going to mix around a bit. So I'm going to wipe some of that off. I can scrape it off with a palette knife as well. Okay, right, we're going in. I'm going to be bold. We have to commit, remember. This is my
hill.
Nothing too extravagant. So we've got the colour on.
Right, now you never see hills with a line like that. So I'm just going to get the top end of the brush here. And I'm just going to make it look like there's some trees in the background on this hill.
Trees in the background. There. Just have not blended that with it.
Now I've got the darker colour here still. I'm going to add some more of the burnt sienna just to make it a little darker. And some green. Touch the phthalo green, just a touch. Good colour. I need more of it. So it's a bit more of the phthalo green. One thing to remember as well when you are doing this, that's why it's quite nice doing sunsets, because colours change the world you look at with the light. But when you put colours on top of your base, it will change it. Because you're mixing pink with blue. Your primary colours and everything. Yeah, so if I put the blue on the sort of the pink, it can kind of come out a bit purpley. So just be aware, not a bad thing, but just so you know. Okay, that's a little bit more. Right, so I'm going to try, I want to do, let's clean that brush up a little bit. I want to do some trees along here. Coming in along here, okay? And then bring it down as a reflection. So this is the background, all right. So load up this brush. Okay, I'm gonna go. Remember, getting the reflection in as well. Make some layout where I want, because I think I'm going to run out of paint again. Where do I want them? I want them along here in front, coming out to about here, I think. Use a lot of paint in this process. A bit smaller. again, when you're remaking more paint up, you get slightly different colours coming through. Just true of any tree, isn't it? It's not all one colour. So go with the flow. Don't stress. I think that's the main thing. So I've got a little bit of the blue, phthalo blue, phthalo green, and the burnt sienna. Making a bit more. That's it, right, it's coming in this bit. A bit too much. Think tree. Ah, that's a goodie. There we go. Nice. Right, now I'm going to do the bit that I love, which is the reflection part. Fairly clean brush. Okay, and we go halfway down here, find the water, the line. Straight down. That's the hardest bit. Making it look straight. Okay, good. And then the clean one. How clean is that? Just like that. Remember, you have to commit, be brave. Very tricky. So with the palette knife again, just going to wipe it off. It's such a mess. It's part of the fun though, isn't it? When you're painting as a child, you always got messy. I don't see why painting as an adult should be any different. So put some more white on here. Right, mix it and you want to. Slice through, so you have a row of paint. Oops, spread it and slice. Okay, get a row of paint on your knife for now. We're going to do what we did last time. You bring out your waterline. Okay, so along here, and it just helps to identify. Oh, I know this little fella. It's further forward. He's, how about that? He's sitting on an island, is he? Maybe he is. He is now. And then they're a bit further behind. Gives you the depth, doesn't it? Depth of the picture. Mm.
And then we want some little ripples. It's a nice little island out there, I think. I'd quite like to visit that island. This bowl, shall we? It's nice. I'm quite happy with that. Right. Now, I'm going to put, might do a little island here and reflect that down as well, shall I? Why not, indeed. So, I'm going for darker colour here. Near the front, and we'll do that. Okay, this is raw umber, this one, for that one. It's not going to be a very big island. I'm not going to do like a massive tree on it. I'm just going to put something, or maybe we'll do it, I don't know. Let's just see what it looks like. Crack on, see where we go. Wipe off the white. Okay. Maybe we'll do a little tree. I'll do a little one. I won't do a massive one, I'll just do a little one, yeah? But it's going to sit about here, so I'm going to do that and just touch. Back and forth. And then I'm just going to take a
trunk. Right. And then mixing all of those colours together, so the remains of this one and this, to make a slightly darker base. More of this, because he's coming down here, isn't he? Yep. Darker. Make that just a bit darker in there. We'll put some more in afterwards. There we go. Okay. Well, there is a method in my madness. So find the line. So where's the shore? This is the edge of it, yeah. So I'll go and then with a clean brush. The same way as we did before with the waterline. Put some of that green in it as well. Yeah, I'll do that. Bit of green in. And where am I? Where am I? Here I am. A little island. So what do I need to do now? I need to put a little bit of white highlight on here, but what I'm going to do, because some of this is still very wet, I'm going to put a little highlight on now, but it's easier once it's dried a little bit. So I'll come back and put the finishing touches on. So this isn't the final piece yet, but you've got the main base of the paint on where you want it to be. I think that's nice and yellow. Quite like this little island. I'll put some dark brown on here when it's drier to make out, so that's the muddy bank maybe. I can try that now, but I think it would be better when it's a tad drier, but let's go. Okay, that's the beauty of oil. You can move it. And then get some fresh highlight here. Pull out the areas. And then you will want darker areas in there as well. But yeah, there we go. That's done for today. Let me have a look. I think that's good for today. So I'll pick this up again when it's dry in a couple of days and do the next bit. But thank you. Clear up now.